Hello dear students, welcome to our channel Pharma Creations. Today we are going to discuss the question paper of summer examination 2022 for semester 3 and the subject is physical pharmaceutics 1, that is BP302T. One by one we will discuss the MCQs from this DBAR2 question paper and then we will see the complete paper of this examination. So this is your MCQ number 1, identify the property not to be considered as a derived property. So derived properties are related with the powder particles. Option A is solubility, B is bulk density, C is angle of repose and D is porosity. So if we see the derived properties of powder particles, bulk density, angle of repose and porosity, these are the derived properties of powders, whereas solubility is not the derived property, it is the physical property associated with the solid substances. So solubility, it is the correct answer for this MCQ, which is not to be considered as a derived property. Next MCQ, mark the state showing faster dissolution. Option A is amorphous, B metastable, C stable and D is all show the science rule. So here if we see the faster dissolution phenomenon, amorphous substances shows the faster dissolution in comparison with the solid crystalline substances. Metastable forms are also shows the maximum dissolution and solubility than the stable and unstable form, and stable forms are also shows the faster dissolution if it is a thermodynamically stable. And last option D is all shows the science rule. So here the correct option is D, that is all shows the science rule, because all these forms are showing their solubility depending upon the rule of science. So D option is correct. Next MCQ, maximum amount of a solute which can dissolve in 100 gram of solvent at room temperature is called. Option A is solubility, B is solution, C is capacity and D is eligibility. So here maximum amount of a solute which can dissolve in 100 gram of a solvent at room temperature is called as a solubility, because solution is nothing but the mixture of solute and solvent is called as a solution. Capacity is related with the measuring capacity of any parameter is called as a capacity, and eligibility is also not the answer. So here the correct answer for this MCQ is solubility. Next MCQ, amorphous substance do not have option A sharp melting point, B is a characteristic geometrical shape, option C regularity of the structure and D is all of the above. So if we see the difference between crystalline and amorphous substances, crystalline form of a substance shows the sharp melting point, whereas amorphous form of substance does not show the sharp melting point. Their characteristic geometrical shape is also not there and regularity of the structure is also not present for the amorphous form of a substance. So option D is correct, that is all of the above. Next MCQ, surfactants are characterized by the presence of option A is water solubilizing and fat solubilizing grow in the same molecule. Option B, only negative charges. Option C, only positive charges and D is none of the above. So here if we see the nature of surfactant molecule, surfactant molecule are having a hydrophilic head and lipophilic tail, and it is characterized by the presence of water solubilizing and fat solubilizing grow in the same molecule. So option A is correct. Next MCQ, the pH of pharmaceutical buffer system can be calculated by. Option A is pH partition theory, B Noyes-Whitney law, C is Henderson-Hasselbalch equation and D is Michaelis-Menten equation. So pH of pharmaceutical buffer system, it is calculated by the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation, hence option C is correct. Next MCQ, the term pH was first used by. Option A is Soren-Peter Lauridsen Sorensen. Option B, Lars Pasteur. Option C, James Kelvin and D is Alfred Coulomb. So here the term pH was first used by the Sorensen's pH scale, and it is used by the scientist, that is Soren-Peter Lauridsen Sorensen. The term pH was first used by the scientist, that is Soren-Peter Lauridsen Sorensen. So option A is correct, and hence it is called as a Sorensen's pH scale. Next MCQ, stalagmometer is used to determine. Option A is viscosity, B is surface tension, C is solubility and D is particle size. So here stalagmometer is not used to determine the solubility and particle size, but stalagmometer, it is used to determine the surface tension. It is also called as a Ostwald's stalagmometer, and if we see the instrument which is used to determine the viscosity, it is called as a Ostwald's viscometer. So stalagmometer is used to determine the surface tension. So option B is correct. Next MCQ, if the gold number is less than the protective action will be, option A is more, B is less, C is half and D is zero. So if we see the relation between the gold number and the protective action of the colloid is, if the gold number is less, then the protective action of colloid is more. It is inversely proportional to each other. So here option A is correct. Next MCQ, if temperature of the liquid is increased, the surface tension will, option A is remain constant, B is increased, C decreased and D is can't be predicted. So if the temperature of the liquid is increased, their collision between the molecule is increased and the surface tension will get decreased. So option C is correct. Next MCQ 11, sorbitan esters used as non-ionic surfactants are, option A twins, B spans, C polar waves and option D is pollux alcalis. So here the sorbitan esters are nothing but the spans. So these are the non-ionic surfactants which are used in the pharmaceutical formulations. So sorbitan esters is nothing but the option B, that is spans. Next MCQ, air permeability method is used to determine the dash dash of powder. Option A is volume, B density, C weight and D is the specific surface area. So air permeability method is specifically used to determine the specific surface area of the powder. So option D is correct. Next MCQ, following gel shows a thixotropic behavior. Option A is bentonite, B starch, C pectin and D is silica. So here the bentonite gel shows the thixotropic behavior. So option A is correct. Next MCQ, the colligative property are related to the, option A is total number of solute particles, B pH, C number of ions and D number of ingredients. So colligative property is related to the total number of solute particles as that of a total number of solvent molecules. So colligative property are related to the option number A, that is total number of solute particles. Next, unit of surface tension is, option A is dyne per meter, B dyne per centimeter, option C cc per mm and D is none of the above. So if we see the unit of surface tension as per CGS system, it is a dynes per centimeter, and if we see the unit as per the MKS system of measurement, it is newton per meter. So unit of surface tension is correct, answer is option number B, that is dynes per centimeter, which is a unit as per the CGS system of measurement. Next, the number of moles of solute per liter of solution is called as, option A is normality, B molarity, C is mole fraction and D is none. So number of moles of solute per liter of solution is called as a molarity, because normality is nothing but the gram equivalent weight of a solute present in 1 liter of solution. So here the correct option is B, molarity. Next MCQ is 17th MCQ. If one part of a solute is dissolved in 1 to 10 parts of solvent, then the solute will be, option A is soluble, B sparingly soluble, C freely soluble and D is none. So if we see the chart of solubility expression, if one part of a solute is dissolving in less than one part of a solvent, then it is called as a very soluble, and if one part of a solute is dissolving in 1 to 10 parts, then it is called as a freely soluble, and if one part of a solute is dissolving in 10 to 30 parts, then it is called as a soluble, and from 30 to 100 parts, it is called as a sparingly soluble, and 100 to 1000, it is called as a slightly soluble. So likewise, the chart is given for the solubility expressions, you can check it in the textbook. But here, for one part of a solute, if it is dissolving in 1 to 10 parts of a solvent, then it is called as a freely soluble. So option C is correct. Next MCQ, particle size and shape can be determined by using, option A is microscopy, B is sieving method, C sedimentation and D is all. So if we see the methods to determine the particle size, then sieving method, sedimentation are used to determine the particle size, but it does not give the measurement for the shape of the particle, whereas microscopy is the technique in which we can measure both particle size and shape. So option A is correct, that is microscopy. Next MCQ, HLB stands for dash dash that are helpful to determine the type of emulsion. Option A is highly lipophilic base, B high low balance, C hydrophilic lipophilic balance and D is all. So if we see the full form of HLB, that is, it is nothing but the hydrophilic lipophilic balance. Option C is correct. Last MCQ 20, determination of surface tension is possibly by, option A is X-ray diffraction, B Kalkfrischer method, see capillary rise method and this is the sedimentation method. So method which is used to determine the surface tension is your capillary rise method, because X-ray diffraction is used for the solid particle measurement. Sedimentation method is also used to determine the particle size, whereas capillary rise method is used to determine the surface tension of the liquid. So option C is correct. So in this way we have discussed the MCQs of this paper. These are the long answer questions for this examination summer 2022. It is a supplementary examination of your semester 3. And if we see the long answer questions, below that the short answer questions are also given. So these are the short answer questions given for this paper. You can write it down for your reference and you can prepare accordingly for your further examinations of semester 3. If you want any explanation for these questions or how to write the answers for any question which is found to be difficult to write the answer, you can comment me in the comment box. So I will explain you the answer for these topics. So suggest me the topic in the comment box. So in this way we have seen this question paper of summer examination 2022 for physical pharmaceutics 1, that is BP302T. For any query you can ask me in the comment section. If you are new on this channel, then don't forget to subscribe my channel, so you will get all the details or the notifications of DBAT2 examinations of your course B Pharmacy. Thank you so much for watching this video.